Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we will learn the most useful methods of string utils and how to use these methods in our code. As we know, string util is a utility class from Apache Com lang package. So okay, let's look at some of the most useful methods of string utils and how they are useful in our code. So here I have created one Java class that is string API new methods, and these are the methods of string utils class, that is empty or blank, and we can use this method to check if string is contain text or not. So how we will use in this code? So let me go to IntelliJ back. So here I will just declare one string. So here I will just call string utils dot is blank, and here I will pass text one as input parameter, and like this we can use another method, that is empty. So let me go back, and here I will just copy this line. So this is first method, so here I will call is empty, and we will learn what is the difference between is empty or is blank method. So first time we will call, so we will get the same input for both methods, is blank or is empty, because here we are passing some text value, so we will get true for both. We will get false because these are not empty or not blank. But what is the difference between is blank or is empty? So is empty method will check if we are getting null or empty space, in that case it will return true. But is blank method will return true in case of we are passing null, blank or with white space also. In these three cases it will return true, in all other cases it will return false, is blank method. But is empty method will return true in case of we are passing null or empty. In case of empty space, it white space, it will return true. So let me check. So here we will just pass empty space, and I will call this function. So for now we will get is blank true, but for is empty it will get false. So let me call this function again. So here we can see the response. We are getting true for is blank method because here we are passing white space, but in case of is empty method we are getting false because here we are passing some space. So we must need to use is blank method if you want to check null or empty. And after that, second function is trim or strip, that we can use to remove the trailing or leading white space from our string. So here let me declare one string, string text2 is equal to with some empty space, white space, and here I will just call, I will just copy system.out.println from here. So here I will call trim method. So trim method will remove the blank space or white space from our string, leading or trailing white space, it will remove both. So here I will just declare one string, response 1 is equal to, so let me just copy this out, and here I will just print response 1, and here we will pass text 2. So let me run this application and check the response. So here we have added white space. If I will directly print the text to value, so we will get like this without trim text to So let me check this response again. So here we can see without trim, it's also printing the white space before ABC. So this is leading white space, and after trim, it has removed the leading white space and just print the string. And the next method is equal or compare. So third method is equals or compares. That method we can use to compare two string in null safe manner. So here I have passed value test 4 is my value and test 5 is also my value, so both values are same. So in that case it will return true if we will call equals method. And if I will call compare to method, so this method will return 0 if both are equals. If both are not equals, in that case it will return -1. So for now we have both values are same, so in that case it will return 0. So let me run this application and check the output. So here we can see the response. Equals method are returning true in case of both values are same, and compare to method is returning 0 because both are same values. If I will change the value, and here I will add 1. So run this application again. So for this time we will get false in case of equals method and -1 for compare to function call. So I have executed. So here we can see equals method are getting false and compare to is getting 1 because both values are different. And now next function is starts with. So here starts with function will check if string starts with the prefix value in a null safe manner. So here we can see our string value is my value, and here I have called test 6 dot starts with AB. So in that case it will check our string is started with AB. In that case it will return true. But if we are not started with AB, then it will return false. So in our case we will get false because our string is started with my, not with AB. So if I will call this application again, so I have run and restarted it again. So here we will get false because our string is not started with AB. So if I will change the value, and here I will pass my, and will run our application again. So in that case now I will get true because our string is started with my, and here our string is my value. So now we are getting true. And next function is ends with, fifth function. So let me check it again. So ends with function, it will check if a string ends with a suffix that we are passing here. So if our string contains suffix ue, in that case it will return true. So here we can see the suffix is ue and it's matching. So in that case it will return true and we will get ends with true response. But if suffix is not matching, in that case we will get false. But in our case it's matching, so now we will get true for ends with function. So let me change, and here I will pass my. So in that case we can see our suffix are not matching, so it will get false now. So here we can see the response, ends with function is returning false because suffix are not matching. So our next function is, that is number 6, is index of, last index of contains. So as we know, index of, last index of and contains method is also null safe. to check the indexes. So here we have string my value, and here we are checking index of a. So here we can see a at m is 0 index, y is 1, and v is 2, and a is at third index. So here we will get the response is 3. And like this we can check the last index of any string. So here we are checking the last index for a. So we can count from last, e is 0 index, 1, 2, 3. So here we can see it is 0, 1, 2, 3, and it's also at third index. So like this we can also call the third function, that is contains. So if we want to check if our string contains a character or a string value, then we can use contains method. So we can see in our string a is present, so we will get true for this function call. So let me call this and run this application again, and we'll check the response for these three functions, index of, last index of, and contains method. So here we can see for index of we are getting 3, and for last index of we are also getting 3, because it's a at third index, 0, 1, 2, 3. And contains method is getting true because our string a is present inside this string value. And our next method is index of any, last index of any, index of any but. So here I am just calling index of any. So here we have passed the same values, may value. And here we are checking the index of a. So what will be the index? 0 and a at first index. For first index we will get here value as a 1. So if I will run this application, we will get the response as 1 for index of any. So here we can see index of any we are getting 1, because a is at 1 index, first index. So let me check another functions. So another function is contains only, contains none, and contains any. So here I am calling contains only method. So contains only method will check if our string contains both these characters a or m. So here we can see our string is containing a and m both. So in that case we will get the response as true. So contains only method will return true because both characters are present inside this string. And next function is contains any. So if any character contains by this string like men, so here we can check a and m are both are present. So in that case we also get true. But if we will use b, and in that case our string any character is matching. So here we can see b is not matching with this string because b is not present inside this string, but a is present. So in that case we will also get true, because any character is matching, in that case we will get true. But in case of contains only, if both are matching, all are matching, only in that scenario we will get true. So in these both cases we will get true response. And the next is contains none. So here we can check if our string contains this character or not. So here we can see our string is containing a or m. So in that case we will get false. So for first case we will get true because both are present inside this string. But only in case of contains any, if any character is matching with this string, so in that case we will get true. And in case of contains none, if both are not matching or any number of characters we can pass, so if these are not matching, only in that case we will get true. If anyone is matching, so we will not get true. So let me run this application. So we will get two true and third is false. So I will run this application again. So here we can see contains only method is getting false because both are matching. So here we are getting false for contains only because here we are just passing two characters and one character n is missing. So if I will pass n here, so in that case we will get true because contains only will match all the characters, and for second contains any, if it is containing any character from this string, so it will get true. So let me change this, and here we will pass c. So now it's not matching, so in that case it will return false, and contains only will return true because all characters are matching, and contains none, so here we will use d and o. So now it will also return true because none is matching. So let me run this application again. So now we will get contains only with false value, with the true value, and contains any will false, and contains none will also true because none character is matching now. And the next function is substring left, right, or mid. And the next function is substring method. So substring method we can use to make or reduce the length of string. For example, if we want to just extract some part from this string, then we can use substring method. So here we will passing our whole string main, and here we have passed index value. So our string will start from index 1 and it will goes up to last index. So our first index is a n. So in this case we will get response as n. So we can subtract or we can make the string short, and we can extract the value from string. So substring method will be used to extract the value from a whole string. So here we can get the response as n. And next function is also like same, string before, string after, or string substring between. So here I am just calling one function from here, string before. So you can also call this function substring after and substring between. So substring extract relative to other strings. So here we can use string t10 is equal to main, and here I will just call string before method. So here we are just passing our whole string main, and here we are passing index value is 1. So it will use before first index. So before first index here is m. So in that case our new string will start from m and up to last index. So in that case we will get response as main. So if I will run this application and we can check the response will be main. So here we can see the output is main because here we are calling string before method, substring before function, and here we are passing index is 1. But if here I will pass the index is 0, so in that case it will also get the same output, that is main. So here we can see the response is same, that is main. So next function is split or join method. So here we are calling split or join method of string util class. So it will split a string into an array. If we will call split array method, split function, it will split the string all character into array, and we can print all the array by using arrays.toString method. So what value we will get after split this string. And if we will call the join method, so join method will join all the splitted array into a single string. So if I will call this, run this application, here we will call get the output like m, and next part is nd, and last is ty. So like this we will get the output. But in case of join method we will get m, and a will be replaced by o because o is using to join this string array. So o, after that nd, and in between nd ty we will join o, we will use o to join, and here we will get the ty. So if I will run this program again, so here this output we are expecting, and we will get the same. So here we can see the output. Our app program is executed. So after split this string with delimiter A, we are getting the output MNDTY. Now we are calling join method. So here we need to pass array of string. So we are using delimiter as O, and here it's joined all the string array. So here we are getting the output is as mon.t. And next function is remove or delete, that is used to remove a part of string. So here I will just execute remove function, and here I have declared one string. REM is equal to www.gainjavaknowledge, and here I am just removing the no from this string. So here we can see no is present here. If it is exactly matched in sequence, then only it will remove. So the sequence of no is matching here. So what will be the output? We will get this output here. So we will get this output. It will remove the no from here. We will get gain java latch. So if I will run this program, so we will get this as the output, www gain java latch. It will remove the no keyword. So here we can see the response. We can see here no is not present after the program executed. Like this, another function is replace or overlay. So it will search a string and replace one string with another. So here I have declared one string. REP is equal to www.gainjavaknowledge, and here I am calling replace method, and here I am just passing three parameter. First is our whole string value, and second is that string we want to replace, what value we want to replace, and this value will be replaced instead of GE. So in our output we will get www.gainjavaknowledge.com, because it will replace GE, it will replace our GE with GE.com. So this is will be the output that we will get once I will run this application. So here we can see the response is www.gainjavaknowledge.com. So like this, we can use replace. We can use replace function if we want to replace any character from our string. So we can use this function and can replace the value. And the next function is chomp or chop, so that we can use to remove the last part of a string. So let me go back to code. So here I am just calling chop method, and this is the string www.gainjavaknowledge. So when I will call string utils.chop, and here I am passing this value www.gainjavaknowledge, so it will remove the last part of a string. So we will get the output is as www.gainjavaknowledge. Up to this we will get our output. So let me run this program and we'll check the response what we are getting. So here our application has executed. So here we can see E is not present in the output because we have called chop method, and chop method is used to remove the last part of a string. And the next function is append if missing. So we can use this function to append a suffix to the end of string if it is not present in that. So here I am calling the function append if missing. So here I have defined one string www.gainjavaknowledge, and here I am calling append if missing, and here I have passed the string value www.gainjavaknowledge, and suffix I am passing .com. If .com is not present here, then it will add after this string and it will be used as suffix, and we will get the response as www.gainjavaknowledge.com. So if I will run this program again, so we will get this output. Let me rerun this application and check the output. And here we can see the append is missing result. We are getting www.gainjavaknowledge.com. But if .com is already present, then what we will get? The response. So we will check and run this application. We will get the same output again. Because this function will append a suffix if it is missing. If it is already present, then it will not add again. So here we can see the response www.gainjavaknowledge.com is only one time. So next function is prepend if missing. So prepend a prefix to the start of string. So prepend if missing function is used if we want to prepend a prefix to the start of the starting of a string if it is missing. So in that case we have declared one string, defined one string, that is gainjavaknowledge.com, but here www dot is missing. So if we want to add this prefix, then we can use prepend if missing function. If it is missing, in that case it will add www dot. So here we can see www dot is not present, so it will add and we will get the output is www.gainjavaknowledge.com. So we will get this response. So if I will run this application and we can check the response. So here we can see the response. In our output we can see www.gainjavaknowledge.com is the output, because here prepend was missing. So this function has added www dot as a suffix, prefix. And the next function is left pad, right pad, center or repeat, that we can use for our string. So this is a left pad, right pad, center or repeat function. So repeat function that we can use if we want to repeat any string, how many times we want to repeat. So we can just pass the value here. So here I am calling string utils dot repeat function, and here I am passing the string, and I want to repeat this string 2 times. So here I have passed number 2. So for this I will get output is 1 2 3 one time, 2 times I will get this output for this function. If I will pass number 3 here, then I will get 1 2 3 3 times. And thus left pad function that we can use if we want to add any prefix before our string. So like this, here I am passing the string as 1 2 3, and size here I have declared 8, and pad character is 0. So our string have only 3 characters. So and here I have declared size 8, so it will append 5 zeros, 3 4 5, after that 1 2 3. So for this I will get this output. So let me run this application and check the response. And here we can see the response. Here I have called repeat function and 3 times. So here we are getting 1 2 3 3 times, 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 3. And here we can see left pad we are using. So there are 5 zeros, after that 1 2 3, because here we have declared the size is 8. If I will declare size 7, then I will get 4 zeros, 4 zeros, after that 1 2 3. So let me run it again. So here we can see the output 4 0, after that 1 2 3. Like this we can use right pad and center function also. And then another next function is uppercase, lowercase or swap case, capitalize and uncapitalize. So it will change the case of a string. For example, if our string is in lowercase and we want to convert it into uppercase, then we can call uppercase function. So here I am calling string utils uppercase, lowercase, swap case and capitalize and uncapitalize function. So in case of uppercase, so here we can see our string input is Evelyn, and here I am just calling uppercase and passing the string. So here I will cut the value is like this, Evelyn in uppercase. So all character will be in the uppercase in output. And if I am using calling capitalize function, so it will make first character as uppercase and another all characters are same. So for third function, that is swap case. So in case of swap, if any characters in this string is in lowercase, it will convert into uppercase, and if already any character in uppercase, it will convert into lowercase. So it will swap. So we will get the response for this string is like this, because a is in uppercase. So if after swapping it will be small case, and valine is in lowercase. So after swap case it will be uppercase character. So if I will run this program and check the output. So here we can see the response in a case of uppercase, all characters will be in uppercase. In case of capitalize, first character will be capital in uppercase and another character will be lowercase. And if we are calling swap case, so if any character in uppercase it will become lower, and if any character in lowercase it will become upper. So like this we can use these functions also. And the next is count matches. So here I am just calling count matches method, so it will count the number of occurrence of any string in another. So this is our string, that is Evelyn, and here we want to get the count for e character. So here we can see e is present 2 times in this string, so we will get the output as 2. So like this we can check the occurrence of any character, how many times this character is present in this string. Then in that case we can use count matches. So let me run this application, and here we can see the response is count matches, we are getting 2 because e is present 2 times in this string. So like this another function is alpha, is numeric, is white spaced, and is ascii printable. So we can also use these functions to check the character in a string. So here I am just calling single function, that is alpha, and we can also use is numeric to check if our string contains only numeric value, and we can also use is white space function if our string contains white space or not. So like this we can also use is ascii printable function. So here we can see our string test is containing all alpha characters. So in that case we will get the output as true. So let me run this program and check the output. So here we can see is alpha is returning true. So let me add one numeric here, 7, 8, and run this program again. So now in that case we can see it is not alpha, it's also containing numeric. So in that case we can see the output is false. Like this we can use isNumeric function to check if our string contains only numeric values or also it's containing numeric or not. So let me run this application again. So run this. So in that case we will just get the true, because here our string is just containing numeric values. So here we can see it's getting true, and here we can just type change the println value or our statement value. So here we can see the numeric is true because our string is containing only numeric or integer values, integer characters. And the next function is default string. So default string, it is a method that is protect against a null input string. So here we can assign any default value to our string. So here we are just assigning default value to response 10 is this value. So if I will run this application, so here I will get the same output, that here we are passing the value. So it will be act as a default string value. So here we can see the response is output as KK, and after that next function is rotate. So here the next function is rotate, that we can use for circular shift. So here we can see our string value is KDBBUI, and here we are just calling string util dot rotate function, and here we are passing this string value, and shift is 2. It means it will rotate last 2 characters. So we will get the output as UI, and KDBB will be the same as it is. We will get So it will just shift two characters in the prefix from last. So let me run this program and we'll check the output for rotate function. So here we can see UI is in front and KDDB is as it is. So it is just shifting two character. So our next function is reverse or reverse delimited. So it is used to reverse a string. So here we can call reverse method from string utils class. So this method will reverse the string value. So like here we are passing the string is man. So after reversing this, after calling reverse function, we will get the output is as NAM. So it will be the output for this application. So if I will run this program for reverse function, we will get the output as this. It will reverse the string value. So here we can see we are getting the output is NAM. So our next function is abbreviate. So abbreviate a string using ellipse or another given string. So here are some rules for a abbreviate function. So if we are passing, we need to pass here two parameters. One is our string and second is we need to pass max width. So if we are passing max width is less than 4, then in that case we will get narrow or illegal argument exception. So like this, if I am passing 3 here as a max width while calling abbreviate function, we will get exception. So we must need to pass at least 4 width here. Minimum will be 4. And in the second case, if the number of character in string is less than or equal to max width, then it will return the string same. So here we can see our number of characters are not less, it's more. So in that case, it will execute this condition. If max width is less than 4, else abbreviate it to substring. So we will get response for this string like this. Because our string value has more characters than 4, so here we will get response like a dot 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 3 dots. So this substring function will be executing internally. So let me run this application and check the output. So here we can see the abbreviate function is returning a triple dot, but in case if string is less character or equal to its width, then we will get whole string as it is. So here I will just pass 4 character. So in that case I will just get the output as a b c d, because in that case our string is less than or equal to max width. So here we can see response is a b c d. If it will be more, then in that case our output will be different. So in that case we will get 3 dots. So here we can see a triple dot. And our next function is difference. So it will be used to compare strings and reports on the differences. So here I have declared two strings and first string is KKUBM and second string is KKUBN. So here we can see the difference is M is present in this string and N is extra in this string. So what will be the output we will get after calling difference function? So in the second string T2, if we are passing any extra character that is not present in first string, so that will be our output. So here our difference will be the N is the output. So it will check the second string or first string, it will compare both string 1 and 2. If any character is extra in second string, that will be the difference. So this is the second parameter. So in that second parameter, if any character that is present here but not in first T1, so it will be the difference. So let me run. So here we will get N as the output. So here we can see difference is n. So if like I will add np, so now I will get response as difference is np, because n and p is not present in upper string. So our last function is Levenstein dist. The number of changes needed to change one string into another then we can call this function. This is deprecated now, so let me call. So here I have declared the string t3 is equal to kkubm and kkubn. So here is only difference of m and n in the last of both strings. So if I will call get left in distance function, then I will get only 1 because difference is of 1 character, so output will be also 1. So this is output, we are getting 1. So these are all functions of string utils. There are some more functions, so it will take more time. So that's enough for today. Thanks for watching this video.